like a V in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens cross the border. Hold up. You know I'm a...
First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. The numbers on the ground for Hunt a week ago. Just downright unbelievable. I mean, when you amass that many yards, I don't know what else to say.
Personally, I thought it was a game for the ages for him. Ripped off some long runs in that contest, didn't he?
He did indeed. Some very long runs, and that total, scary. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. And they tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization.
And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Carl Lawson with a little help. How do you do as he gets in there for the sack? 5 yards. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Football 101, you've got to let the guy. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. First down, Mayfield. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell, and he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, Mayfield. Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line. A big play that time for Cleveland. 45 yards. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Brings up second and 9.
Mayfield gives this one to Hunt. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage. And now third and 11 coming up.
Third down.
On third down, Mayfield. And he's got his tight end. It's Hooper for the Browns touchdown.
Complete to Austin Hooper.
Austin Hooper. His first touchdown on the year. And the Browns get a score closer. So back to live action. Let's see what this offense can do here on this play. The 30 to about the 33-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4.
On 2nd down, it's Hunt. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. 12 yards there and a first down. We should mention, to go along with a great game he had last week, he was rightfully named AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
And he shares that with his offensive line, the tight end, his fullback. He's looking for more and more of that in this game.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Von Bell up to make the tackle.
Brings up 2nd and 10.
They'll try to throw here. Mayfield. That's complete to Taywan Taylor. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 33. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 down at the 33.
Kareem Hunt, the Cleveland ball carrier. Geno Atkins on the stop.
Big Geno Atkins there to bring him down.
Second and five at the 29-yard line.
From the 29, Mayfield. And this is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Taywan Taylor, and it's third and five. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Now Mayfield. They'll go screen here to Hunt. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
Mayfield's pass.
A good play there as the Browns strike for 16 and a first down. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And he'll be dropped at about the 11 after only a yard.
Kareem Hunt, the ball carrier, taken down at the 11-yard line. A gain of a yard brings up second and 9.
On second and 9, Mayfield. Touchdown, Cleveland!
Mayfield on the keeper. Touchdown, Cleveland.
Well, the defensive coverage was good, so good, he just decided to make a play of his own, and it worked out.
Yeah, you often wonder if they think to themselves, was the coverage too good to allow him to run the football? But I think you'd rather take your chances with him doing exactly that, and he beat him on that play all the way to the end.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They'll start with Hunt on the ground. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7. Past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled at the 32.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and 3.
Second and 3.
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And he rifles it complete, caught by Landry. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
A gain of 11 on the play.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Throwing left side here, and it's complete.
Mayfield.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory.
On the play.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Past the 20! And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. It's a gain of 35. He had his eyes on the end zone once he hit the secondary, but they're finally able to slow him down.
Yeah, and I've got to look at this one from the defensive point of view. You just mentioned finally able to slow him down. They've got to figure out a way to make that at the point of attack, at the line of scrimmage, because once he gets through, he's shredding them.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down.
Second and 1 at the 2-yard line.
Now Hunt. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down. And a heavy set out there. 3 tight ends in the formation for 3rd and 3. And they'll let their fullback try and push the pile. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. Nothing doing on 2nd and 3rd down after that 9-yard gain on 1st.
With the way things have gone in this game, I think they've got to consider going for it here. I realize it's just the 2nd quarter, so they're not panicking, but they need something to give them positive momentum to get things going.
17.
Now following the field goal, what can this offense do? We're about to find out. Mayfield now looking to throw on 1st down. And this one caught by Dez Bryant.
Mayfield's pass.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. Now Mayfield lost the football. And the Bengals have recovered it. So we are in the final minute now of the 1st half as this offense gets ready to take over. A 1st down throw from Mayfield. He'll find Taylor. That's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Browns will use the 1st of their 3 timeouts.
First down.
As they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. He's going to fire one deep over the middle, and that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left.
Incomplete on the jump ball.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Going to the air again with Mayfield. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And they do finally get him, but he makes it all the way to the 6. Now a timeout called with 3 seconds to go. And, of course, they're in field goal range in the final seconds of this first half.
A 23-yard attempt.
And the former Buckeye, Nugent, puts this one through. Offense gets set to take over. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go.
But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
33-yard line.
On second and 2, Mayfield. Throw right side, taken in by the tight end, Bryant. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there.
A gain of 9 yards.
Now, that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, a tight, sharply run route. Again, zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion.
Brings up second and 8.
They run again with Hunt. Dodges him at the 50. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. It's a gain of 6. Moves him to a manageable 3rd and 2 situation. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Mayfield now from the 50. They'll roll him out right. He may try and run for this. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 4 yards there as they let him out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first. On 1st and 10, Mayfield going deep here for Landry. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Jarvis Landry, Pro Bowl wideout, the intended receiver. That'll bring up 2nd down. They'll run with Hunt on 2nd down. A 1st down.
Brought down at the 30-yard line.
It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner, because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out on every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
Kareem Hunt.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
He completes it to Bryant. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8.
But remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
This is the fullback, Janovich, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal.
No gain on the play.
Nothing on 1st down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, 2nd and goal. And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1-yard line.
Kareem Hunt, the ball carry.
7 big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with 3rd down upcoming. Big play coming here. It's 3rd and goal. They'll try and run it in with Janovich, the fullback. And he takes this one in for a Brown score. Andy Janovich. Now the offense back. Up quickly there as he gets it up only to about the 17. Making the play defensively, Carl Lawson. He's going to be stopped here for no gain. And that's going to take us to the end of the third quarter play. Back now in Cincinnati. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. The Browns on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Mayfield looks to throw. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Tech McKinley made his way into the backfield. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings it right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Mayfield on first down. Catch right side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. Now they go screen. It's complete. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable 2nd and 1. Looking downfield, and that's caught right side. He's got his man. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 35. 15 yards on the play, first down. That's complete to his running back, Taylor. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. He's got his man on the crossing route. What a throw right there for the first down. He has taken some real punishment in this game, but still standing in the pocket completing that one.
He's a flat-out warrior. There's no question about that. How about him stepping up into the teeth of the rush and delivering there for that big strike and that big pickup?
He had to fight that time. Ran through one tackle, but ultimately he's only going to get back to the line of scrimmage.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
And his throw here is incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
And he is going to be stopped at the 12, short of the first down. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
This has been an up-and-down, back-and-forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive took a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settled things down a little bit.
The kick is good. Makes the score, Bengals 37.
Both offenses have been clicking in this one. A lot of points on the board. We'll see if that trend continues. Mayfield to throw it. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
Now left side on the swing pass. And he works free. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That one good for 26 and a first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
Intended for Taylor.
So line of scrimmage still with 39 on 2nd and 10.
To 2nd and 10.
Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
I thought that wasn't a bad time to call the screen. I thought late game, down on the scoreboard, had to figure they were expecting a pass downfield.
So the edge rushers, they're coming. That could have hit big. You're right. Good recognition defensively to snuff that one out. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses, understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Give them credit. They knew what they wanted to dial up on fourth. They executed it for 9 yards, and the offense stays out there. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And they'll get this down to the 10. The Browns passing game finding its stride. They've got another first down. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 8 and a good first step there with second and goal coming up. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punt? And he's in. Touchdown, Browns. Kareem Hunt with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Browns. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Throwing, Mayfield. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
It's a gain of 20. First down, Browns.
Here's Mayfield. Going right side here, and that's complete. And this will complete. He's got it.
Mayfield's pass.
First down now, but that clock rolling.
Mayfield's pass.
That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Mackenzie Alexander with a pick. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong, whatever you call it.
Hey, yo. Yeah. Nike check. I done made about 1 million and I'm only 19, huh? I see water dripping on